Namaste and welcome to Namaste Yoga. My name is Surbhi. I'm a yoga teacher. The goal of my channel is to tell you all those little tips and tricks that many yoga teachers know, but somehow in class setting, they do not get conveyed to the students. I have been getting a lot of requests about Ardhasiddhasana. Show us how to do Ardhasiddhasana. This is Ardhasiddhasana, and I will be telling you today how you can sit in Ardhasiddhasana without any discomfort. But before we start, let's get some facts straight. Yoga or Ardhasiddhasana is not a magic. If you think you are not able to do Ardhasiddhasana, you are going to watch this video, learn some tips, and you will be able to do it in 2 to 3 weeks. Then I am sorry to say, but this is not going to happen. This is not a magic. If you still want to continue, you can keep watching the video. Otherwise, don't waste your time. However old you are, maybe 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 60, however old you are, that is how long you have practice of sitting in wrong posture or sitting slouching down like that, or not folding your legs, because these days all of the people are sitting on the couch or chair or office chairs. They don't really fold their legs. So that many years of bad habit you have in your body. Your body is used to sit like that. In order to sit comfortably in Ardhasiddhasana, you need to have flexible knees, flexible pelvic joint, flexible SI joint, and a good spine posture. Then Ardhasiddhasana would be very easy for you. So I will be telling you today what you can do to open up your pelvic muscles, open up your SI joint, and make your posture good. But having a constant practice 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and for so many years, however old you are, weighs a little higher than doing yoga practice for 1 hour or 30 minutes a day. So you need to take care of some things that you do on regular basis that will really expedite your process of sitting in Ardhasiddhasana. The very first thing is try to sit in Sukhasana, or try to sit with your legs folded as much as possible. Whenever you're sitting anywhere, just like that, legs folded. Whether you're sitting on the couch watching TV, you are eating dinner on dining table, I usually sit on the dining table with my legs folded. So as much as you can, try to sit with your legs folded. That will train your muscles to keep your legs in folded position, and your journey to comfortable Ardhasiddhasana will start. Second thing, our lower back. When we sit, when I say comfortable spine, so your spine should be at its natural curve. And naturally in our lower back, there is a curve right here. So when you sit, try sit in that way that you are not losing this curve. So you are not going down like this. So sit with a cushion or a blanket underneath you. Put a blanket underneath and just keep sliding forward till you feel a little tilt, till your hip bone comes on the edge of the blanket, and you will feel that your pelvic is tilted a little bit. That will force your lower back to move forward and come in the natural curve. So whether you are sitting on the office chair or on the ground, try to sit like this. So these are the two things that you need to focus on regular basis. Other than that, what you can do so your body feels comfortable sitting in Ardhasiddhasana. First of all, practice Baddha Konasana. Now Baddha Konasana also you can practice whenever you are sitting down. You, as I said, watching TV, just sit like this. So keep your both of your heels together, feet together. Try to bring your heels as close to your pelvic as possible. If you cannot, it's okay. You can keep them far, but at least start practicing. Make your muscles get used to it, and slowly, slowly you will be able to bring them closer. If your knees are high, it's okay, don't worry about it. Just start doing it. Once you are doing it, then imagine, I will show it to you from the side. Then imagine that someone is pushing you from your lower back. Just like I said, use the blanket and tilt a little bit. Either you can do that or just imagine someone is pushing you from your lower back. So when you inhale, imagine that push. So your lower back goes up. Imagine it's getting higher. Now inhale, keep it higher, and exhale, bend forward. Then again, inhale, keep it higher, exhale, bend forward. When you do that, you will be able to feel the stretch on your lower back as if your vertebrae are getting longer. Someone is pulling you. Do that and just try to go as far as possible. If you cannot go all the way, it's fine. However much you can, every time you inhale, pull your lower back, pull your spine up. Every time you exhale, bend forward. Inhale up, exhale down. And the same way, come back, keeping your back straight. Inhale up, exhale back, keeping your spine straight. So this is the way, Baddha Konasana. Even if you don't have to come forward all the time, if you're watching TV, talking to a friend, just sit like this. Just sit like this normally. Second thing that you can do is Titli Asana or Butterfly. Keep your feet this way in Baddha Konasana. And many people, when they do Titli Asana, they just do that. This is not doing any good. When you do Titli Asana, you need to move your legs to full up and down. And while you're doing that, your breath should be a little deeper. I have my mic very close to my nose. So when I breathe, it's going to be loud. You're not supposed to breathe loud. You're supposed to breathe deeper. So first, take a deep breath. Relax. And then start breathing a little deeper and start flapping. Full flaps up and down. If you start to get tired, you can reduce the speed, but do not reduce the distance of your flaps. So don't start doing this. Reduce the speed, but do full flaps. That will open up your pelvic joint. Third thing, in order to make your spine strong and flexible, you can do is cat-cow breathing. For cat-cow breathing, come on all four. The key to come on all four is distance between your knees should be one arm. So one arm distance between your knees. And the distance between your knees and your hands should be one arm and a palm. And then you come on all four. If you measure this properly, then your shoulder and your wrist should be in one line, and your hips and your knees should be in one line. Once you have this, as you start to inhale, look up, chin up, belly drops down. You should be looking all the way up, so you feel a little stretch on your throat. And keep breathing, do not hold your breath. And once you start to exhale, keep exhaling, curl your back, chin to chest. Keep breathing, do not hold your breath. Then again, inhale, look up, chin up, belly drops down. Keep breathing, exhale, curl your back, chin to chest. Come to the center. So do this at least 10 times, or based on your capacity. Every person is different. Some people might feel tired after 2-3 times. Some people maybe they can do for 20 times. So it's totally your choice. There is no cap on it. You can do as much as you want. This will strengthen your lower back and bring that curve in your lower back. Once you start to feel comfortable doing it, then you can add your legs. So once you inhale, look up, chin up, raise your right leg up. When you're raising your right leg up, make sure you're only raising your leg, you're not turning your hips like this. So keep your hips looking down, only raise your leg. If you cannot raise your leg all the way up, however much you can do is fine, but don't turn your hips up. And when you exhale, bring it down. Then again, inhale, look up, chin up, raise your leg. Exhale, down. Keep switching the legs. Now, when we are doing the legs, many times people ask me, when we bring our leg back, it doesn't come back at the same point. So it moves forward or backward. So what you can do is keep your toes touch to each other. So when you are bringing your leg up, inhale, and when you are bringing it down, touch your toes. That way, it will be a nice guide for you where to stop. Once you feel improvement in your flexibility, in your sitting posture, that when you fold your legs, you're not hurting so much. So once you feel a little bit of improvement, then you can add Shishupalasana or rock the baby in it. I'm taking Shishupalasana at the end because this asana needs a lot of back strength. Shishupalasana, keep your left heel close to your pelvic and make a baby with your right leg. So your heel goes under your elbow and you hold your knee like a baby like this. You might not be able to do it this at the first time. Many people cannot keep their leg up. They can only do this much. It's okay, just do this much. However much high or low your leg goes, it's totally fine. It's okay. Just make sure that you're not compromising your spine. Your posture should remain straight. So even if you can do this much, it's fine. So make a baby with your leg, keep your posture straight. And then again, start taking a little deeper breaths. Not louder, deeper. Deep breaths and rock the baby like that. However long you can do this, 10 seconds, 30 seconds, 1 minute, start building up to it. You should be able to do it at least for 2 minutes. All the time, keep your spine straight, keep your posture straight, and then relax. And don't forget to do the same thing on the other leg. So this time, keep your right leg close to your pelvic. Make a baby with your left. Spine should be straight. And rock the baby. So, do this for at least 2 minutes or build up to 2 minutes. As you feel that your body starts to open up, the time to sit in Shishupalasana will also increase. As your body starts to open up, you will see that you're able to sit in Ardha Siddhasana for a long period of time. Now, how to sit in Ardha Siddhasana? Keep your left heel close to your pelvic. It should be touching your perineum. If it's not touching, it's okay. Don't worry about it. Maybe it's just because you're not flexible enough. It will eventually get there. So keep your heel close to your pelvic and your right leg in front of your left. That's it. Both of your sit bones should be on the ground. If this knee is coming up, it's okay, don't worry about it. If you want, you can just put a blanket underneath like that so your muscles don't get tired and you don't get agitated in between your dhyan practice. But please, please, please do not make this a crutch. Don't rely on this. Do all the exercises I told you and build your body so you can do it without the support of the blanket. So just keep your heel close to your pelvic and the right leg comes in front of the left. Hands in Dhyan Mudra. Spine straight at its natural curve. This is Ardha Siddhasana. So practice all the exercises that I told you. Specifically, please start sitting with your legs folded and with the curve in your lower back. That will be very helpful. I hope you enjoyed the video today. If you have any question or concern, please feel free to write it in the comment box. I would love to answer that. If you have not done so, please subscribe to the channel and click on the notification bell so you know when my next video is coming. I wish you all a very happy and healthy day. Namaste.